What's going on, YouTube fam? Jeff from Two Wheels and a Meal here. Enjoying some nice view ropes. Just blessed to live in such a beautiful area here in the Central Virginia, Shenandoah Valley area. Blue Ridge Parkway, mile marker 1 is right there. Meets up with the Skyline Drive. Just incredible views and incredible roads to ride on here in my area, man. And you don't really think about it too much until you leave and you're like, man, I miss those roads. Those are good roads, man. Good turns. And today we're balling on a budget. we have a limited amount of money. We got $20 to fill up the bike and get some food today. Which we should be able to manage that. And we're heading into Charlottesville, Virginia. Balling on a budget. Balling on a budget, man. I like it. So we'll roll this intro. We'll see you guys on the bike. This shit way too formal. Y'all know I don't follow suit. It's AC Dash. Most of these girls ain't got a clue. All of these hoes I made on records I produce. I may take all my exes and put them all in a group. Hit my essays. I need the booch. About to turn this fuck shit in the bottom room. Told her I've been. You coming too. In the 305. Bitches treat me like I'm a groom. It's just a roof. She said, where we going? I said, whoa, whoa. We ain't even making to the room. Balling on a budget, a new series by Two Wheels and a Meal. What do you guys think, huh? I fuck with it because I'm broke. I ain't got no money. The pandemic has fucked my life up. I need a new hustle. I need to find something else to do. Obviously, YouTube don't pay no fucking money. I just do this for fun. I mean, right now, it's almost December 1st, and I'm still out here riding and making videos, and, you know, it's not that bad. We're in Central Virginia, and it's still lower 50 degrees. But I'm still out here on this fucking machine having a good time. I love this motorcycle. Love it, love it, love it. I need a new one. But we'll jump across that bridge when we get there. I still want to keep this one and have a new one. That's my problem. Like, I don't want to, like, you know, sell this for whatever I get for it and then upgrade. I want to keep this one because, like, it's sentimental for me, man. I've had it over 10 years. I've had this motorcycle more than anything else in my whole life. You know, aside from, you know, a couple loved ones and stuff like that, but this motorcycle has been in my life and a part of my life for over a decade, man. And that's fucking love. I love you, baby. You leave me stranded a couple times, but it's all love. Now, like I said, we're on the way to Charlottesville. I got the tunes going in my ears. I got some 90s R&B and rap, and we're straight vibing, man. They putting on No Diggity right now while I'm trying to talk to you guys, and it's got me hella distracted. And I get going, wow. Dude, I'm fucking straight vibing, man. Thanks for watching. If it's your first time, my name's Jeff. This is my YouTube channel. I'm a cook for a living. We kind of take that on my motorcycle. Obviously love to ride my bike. And we ride to restaurants and get some bomb ass food, man. And we don't really like review it per se, but you know, we talk about our experience and really have a good time along the way. So make sure you hit the like, make sure you subscribe, man. We're fucking straight vibing out today. And thank you for joining me. Let's see you guys when we get a little bit closer to Charlottesville. Let's get it. I like the way you work it. I like to bag it up. So yeah, there's usually a few food trucks over here. I'm just kind of scoping it out. I don't really know where I'm gonna go yet, and also need to get gas first. So what do we got here? Tacos Gomez. I've had that, not on the vlog. It's really good. And then Comida Latina. They look open as well. Okay. So we're rolling to downtown, see what else we can see here. Oh, the pie chest. So they're busy as fuck right now. Oh, tacos. Oh man. Thai Southeast Asian. My chico's over there. Indian restaurant. Oh, that looks like a good place, man. Quality pie. Sounds good to me. God damn. And that's literally why I fucking record every single second while I'm on this motorcycle. Because motherfuckers don't look. You gotta fucking look. God, it stressed me out. I was vibing. So I've been riding around Charlottesville for like an hour, man. And there's just so much to choose from. You know, this is like 8 times bigger than where I live, man. There's 8 times as many people. There's 8 times as many restaurants. You know, and that's the problem with me not having an agenda. I get sidetracked. I can't figure out exactly what I want to eat. You know, and I'm just struggling trying to find something to eat. What's that, burgers and donuts? I bet you they put a burger and a donut together there. And it slaps. That's on me for not having the agenda, you know. That's my ADD kicking in. I've looked on the internet for a couple places and a lot of them aren't open yet. So I'm just kind of struggling on trying to find a cheap eat. Something good and different for all of us to enjoy together. So I'm gonna do one more lap here. We're gonna figure it out. If all else fails, there's freaking tacos. So, I mean, that should be my slogan. If all else fails, tacos. Oh, there's Cava. I forgot about Cava. What's going on over there? Maybe we can go to Cava today. Might be vibing with that. All right, folks, my tummy has spoken. I'm tired of looking around. This place was always on the agenda. I used to always hype it up in the videos when we rode by. I'm like, oh, I'm gonna take you guys there. I'm gonna take you guys there one day, blah, blah, blah. Well, today's that freaking day. We're going to Cava. It's kind of like Chipotle, but with Greek ingredients. You choose your greens and your grains, and then they have like, you know, skewered kebab chicken and all kinds of Greek treated meat and or, you know, tofu if you're not into meat. Lots of roasted vegetables to go in there. It's basically like a green and grain bowl place, but just kind of Mediterranean style here. It doesn't look very busy right now. We'll see if we can actually order. It might be closed. Skirt. Looks like they're open. There's people in there. Hell yeah. Sweet. We're gonna get the helmet and the gear off and we'll get set up. We'll see what we can get for lunch. It already smells amazing. Let's go. Put the city on slam. She get trippy off Zens, lost 21 grams. And she did it on cam. When no video dance. Make my own rules. I really don't pick, I just choose. I don't set picks, I just shoot. Chopping it screwed. I told her it's BYOB. That mean buy your own boobs. Put it on God. He the one to put me on top. Can't be put in a box. Gotta move on the ops. Never got the move on the drop. Niggas tryna move on the sky and move that deep. Tryna run down shit steep. Gotta act a fool with the squad. Next city, no sleep. Back to the 713. Spent 10 hours on this flight, man. Told the pilot ain't no flight plans. Can't believe whatever I'm saying. And they know whenever I land. Yeah. We're kind of at a major intersection here, so I'm sorry for any traffic noise, but we've arrived at Cava. We got our harissa honey hot chicken bowl here with grains and greens. I got feta cheese, some crispy bits, and pickled onions. But yeah, it smells amazing. This might not be the prettiest meal, but tell you what, the flavors that are in here are incredible. Pickled onions, arugula, got some crispy bits. So this bowl was about $12. Had to pay a little bit extra for the chicken that I wanted, but it's totally worth it. I forgot I got hummus and tzatziki in there, roasted corn. We've got it going on. Well, since it is so noisy around here, I'm gonna go ahead and finish this up. We'll get gear back up and get on the bike, and then we'll talk a little bit more about everything that I had here today at Cava. What I do know, cops just pulled up next to the bike. Wasn't me this time, allegedly. I'm good. The cop went inside. I'm good. Thought I was going to jail. All right, fools. We're leaving Cava. It's delicious. So like I was telling you guys, it's like Chipotle with the Mediterranean, you know, flair in there. Everything was really good, man. Each individual thing had its own distinct flavor, you know. Like the olives were treated, the onions were pickled, the meat had proper seasoning. There's like roasted corn in there that had different seasoning in it. And it was just really, really solid flavors all around. And what's cool is like I built it how I wanted, you know what I mean? Like, so the next time I go there, I could build something different and it could taste kind of different, you know what I mean? So that's what I really enjoyed about it. It came with a cute little pita bread. It was perfect. Perfect size, you know what I'm saying? Made a little taco pita action. It was hitting, dude. So this guy across the street is Black Lives Matter. He's been going ham. I could hear him the whole time I was eating. And I love this guy's energy right now. I'm about to give him a good rev. Woohoo! I love that dude's energy, bro. He's like straight vibing. And that's something I can get behind. Yet again, another delicious lunch here in Charlottesville. I like coming here, man. There's so many choices and a lot of good food. It's like, why not, man? My town, there's, you know, there's fucking 20 choices and I've been to all of them 20 fucking 100 times. So, it's good to come out and explore some and try something new and try something different. Get out of your comfort zone. So I've never had harissa before until today, and apparently it's spicy as shit. I had no idea, so I got the harissa hot honey chicken, and then more harissa sauce on top of it. Folks, two thumbs up. You guys have to go try Cava. Really, really solid flavors. Like I said, each item that I had in my bowl was treated different. So I know it looked like just like a big old bowl of mush, but everything had its own distinct flavor, texture, and something that it brought, you know, flavor that it brought to the bowl. The corn was fire roasted. The rice even was seasoned. It was nice and yellow, nice good flavor. You know, arugula has its own peppery flavor. So if you guys are looking for something different to eat, go check out Cava. I'm pretty sure they're a chain because I've seen some in other cities near me, not just here in Charlottesville. I've seen one in Richmond and Short Pump. Really cool concept, you know, like it was like an assembly line. I started with the grains and greens, and then the next thing, you know, I chose my beans, whichever, you know, they had five or six different beans to choose from, and I went to my meat and see which meat I wanted. There was a bunch of different options and vegetarian options and vegan options, and then I went on to my sauces and toppings and dressings and Like I said, I got hummus in there. I forgot about that. Tzatziki in there. So it had a lot of Greek flavors going on. And it hit that spot. I was getting hangry. I was riding around. I'm like, man, where am I going to go eat? I'm fucking taking forever trying to figure out where I want to go. And I was getting hangry. Dead ass. But now it's all good. I'm a happy boy. And I'm heading home before the sun goes down. Because once that sun goes down, it starts getting frigid around here. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit thumbs up. Share with your friends. Make sure to subscribe for more. And thanks for coming along with me today. We were straight vibing. And that's what it's all about. So once again, I've been Jeff from Two Wheels and a Meal. Until the next episode. La 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 da 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 da. And for the record, I did not go over budget. I did not go over budget. I had $20 to spend. I put $5 in gas, which basically filled this up. They had a little bit in there. I bought a little coffee at the store, which was a nitro cold brew coffee, which is kind of expensive. It was $3.50. And then the bowl, which was another $13, rounded up. Or $13.56. I'm right there, man. Just a couple dollars over 20. I did pretty good. Not bad. The first attempt at the broke boy vlogs, if you feel. That's what it's about, man. I released a vlog today. Went out and filmed a vlog today. Got tons of pictures, man. I'm just stacking it up, man, because here in a month, I'm not going to be able to ride at all. So I still want to be able to release content to you people. And still be active on my social media, my YouTube. And I've been releasing a video every other week for almost 2 years now. Which is, wow, my mind's blown. Almost got 50 videos. And it was cool. I was looking back, watching some of my old videos, you know, seeing some of the things I used to do and talk about and how I used to edit. And, you know, it's a reflection on where you've been and where you're at now. You know what I mean? And I see progression in my videos. I see progression in my editing, and I see progression in my everything and riding in life. It's good to go back and reflect on that and where you've been and where you want to go and where you want to be. Name off some good spots in the comments that you guys have been to that I need to check out. So as we ride into the sunset, thank you for joining me for another video. I'm Jeff from Two Wheels and a Meal. Until the next episode. La da 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 da. You know what they say, man. The best way to see the sunset is to ride into it.